So hi, I'm Damian Dinning, and I'm the lead program manager for imaging experience for Nokia smart devices. There are three key things that we had to make breakthroughs in to make this happen. The first one is the sensor, 41 megapixel sensor. And genuinely there are 41 megapixels on that sensor. We've had people questioning whether or not we're upscaling or anything like that. Maybe it's a 20 megapixel sensor which we're upscaling. It's genuinely 41 megapixel sensor. As you can probably guess, you can't just go and get one of those things off the shelf. They just don't exist. So we had to co-develop that sensor. So that was the first thing that we had to do. The second thing was, with a sensor that's able to resolve that amount of detail, we had to introduce new optics. We worked closely with Carl Zeiss, collaborated with them, to produce optics that have, roughly speaking, the precision of about 10 times higher than in SLR lenses. So that was the second thing. The third area was then in terms of the imaging pipeline. So, for example, in video, when we're recording 1080 video, we are handling over 1 billion pixels per second, which is about 16 times the number that you'll be able to handle in a regular smartphone that handles 1080 video. And you also have that full field of view, by the way, which I don't think you get in any other devices that I'm aware of, at least, that record 1080 video. So those are the breakthroughs that we had to make. Now, of course, everybody's talking about the 41 megapixels, but really for us, the story is not about the number of megapixels, but how we're actually using those pixels. That's the really big deal. So the two key things that we're doing here. First is oversampling, and this allows you to capture and create 5 megapixel images, which are about 1 megabyte, which have significantly more detail than any other camera smartphone you've ever used or exist in the marketplace today, by a long way, not by a small way, a huge margin. So that's the first thing. And incidentally, I should add to that, that pixel oversampling also allows in low light a significant reduction in noise. So your images captured in low light are significantly better than you've ever been able to produce before. And the second area that this very high resolution sensor allows, which is the primary reason why we developed it in the first place, is the zoom capability. So in stills, you have roughly 3 times lossless zoom, and video, full 1080, you have 4 times lossless zoom. And if you record in 720 video, that will give you the capability to have 6 times zoom. In fact, you could even go further and use the 360p setting, and that would give you 12 times zoom, completely lossless.
So if we could forget about this digital zoom thing that old cameras have.
We had great delight in completely disabling digital zoom. There's no digital zoom in this device whatsoever. There's no upscaling at any point, whatever you're using, video or stills. It's purely based on the resolution that the sensor has available to it. So we preserve the maximum capability of the optics and the high resolution sensor. This combination provides us a number of unique benefits over optical zoom. So for example, we have a very large maximum aperture of f2.4 that's throughout the zoom range. It's not affected by the zoom that you're using. Unlike optical zoom, typically when you zoom in, for example, 3 times zoom might end up being 5.6, we're still 2.4, which means we have 5.4 times the amount of light reaching our sensor throughout the zoom than you would get with conventional optical zooms. It's completely silent as well. So it means when you're shooting video, you're not going to hear any noise from the zoom motor or anything like that, because there isn't one. I can see a lot of people who currently have N8s wanting to make the upgrade to this device. A lot of logic in that. I think there's also going to be a lot of people who, the kind of people who are interested in photography, either at enthusiast level or even at a level where they just want to take great pictures really easily. Who will be really interested in this product. We saw a similar thing with the N8, incidentally. So the PureView is the technology which we're introducing, which is a combination of high-performance optics, high-performance sensor, and Nokia industry-leading image processing algorithms. There's a number of different ways that we can utilize those elements together. And what you'll see over time is us using different combinations of those in our future lineup.